Hello fellows, how are you? I'm good and I'm really excited today. I'm going to discuss today an important thing or important tutorial that's gonna help you to minimize your downtimes and it will help you to automate your server management in AWS. And that is using Route 53 health check, AWS Lambda and SNS. The concept here is that AWS has a service Route 53 which has a subservice health check which does monitors your application's uptime on daily, on a minute basis or second basis. And when your application goes down, then the health this health checks creates an alarm which can be catched with a SNS. The alarm can trigger an SNS and an SNS can be linked with a lambda function. So the point here is when your application goes down, then the health check creates an alarm in SNS and then SNS either sent you an email and also can invoke a lambda function. And as we know, lambda has a lot of possibilities and one of them is they can reboot your instance. So is that ring a bell? That means this is the ultimate solution of 90% of the problems. Most of the problems I see when server goes down is just reboot the instance. Just reboot the instance, most of the cases. I mean, not all cases, but most of the cases. So, if you can automate this, then if it goes down at the middle of a night, you don't need to worry about it because it automatically reboots and your application goes up. So, this is a solution where you have a kind of limited human resources to manage your server and you want to automate this. However, this is not applicable for all projects and all solutions are basically not applicable to all projects. These are specific to some projects which is you can just reboot and fix your issues. So if your application is delicate or it requires human involvement, you want to root cause the issues, then do not try to follow this approach. There are you need to better manage it via some other process. But this is this solution is for applications where you just reboot the instance, your application is up again. So this solution might work over here. Okay, let's do this. How we can do that? I go to Route 53. So I go to Route 53 and then I go to health check. Health check is a basically uptime monitoring service of AWS where you can monitor your applications and all of those things. So just let's create a health check. Okay, let me give a name here. I give a name like C test. Then we need to give a domain name which we want to monitor, and let's give a domain name which I just created. Okay, yesterday I created this subdomain for testing, so let's I just put it here, and it can be both HTTP and HTTPS. I just choose HTTP. HTTPS is a bit expensive. So let's go next. Okay, now I need to create an alarm. An alarm which will trigger an SNS, an SNS which will trigger a lambda function. So let's do this. Create a new SNS topic. I give ctest. I give my email address. Then I'm going to create next. So my health check has been created, and as you can see, this is my health check and this is showing fine. If I go to alarms, then I'm going to see the alarm here. Now if I go to this alarm, then probably I will see my own email address by default as a subscriber. So you can subscribe to a topic in SNS, and then okay, this is the alarm, and now we go to SNS area. SNS. We have four topics, and this is just I created Ctest. And if I see the email addresses, these are my email addresses which are pending confirmation. Okay, now I can create another subscription, which is a lambda function. Okay, so I need to create the lambda first. So let's go to topics, Ctest, fine. Then I'm going to go to lambda. And then I'm going to create a function. I'm going to create the function from scratch. The function name is Ctest Reboot. And the runtime is Python 3.7. The role, I have already created a role previously, so I will use an existing role. But if you haven't created previous roles, you need to create a new role for the lambda function to execute these steps. So I'm going to use this lambda star stuff EC2. That's the role that I need. I just created this, but you can also create a new role. Just make sure that these roles have access to EC2 and CloudWatch. I just, for simplicity, I just gave EC2 full access and CloudWatch full access. That's it. Okay, this is my basic lambda. I have written the lambda in my notepad previously, so let's just copy this. It's a pretty simple. You just put here, you just need to use this library Boot3, which has access to a lot of built-in functions for AWS related applications. So I'm going to import Boot3. I need to set the region EU-1, but you need to change it based on your own region. And instance, this is my dummy instance ID, so it's not correct. You need to copy your instance ID from your EC2 and need to put it there. After that, this part is pretty much safe. There is no need to change anything on this area. You can just copy it. But it creates a Boot3 client for EC2, and then it just calls the function reboot instances, and the parameter is the instance ID, and then that's it. It just reboots the instance. So let me go further and check everything is fine. Just make sure that this is 1 minute. All is done. Let's save. Okay, then I go to my SNS. Here I need to add a subscriber, so create a subscriber. the protocol is lambda and the endpoint is ctest reboot. Okay, so you can just search it here, or you can also copy it from this particular area. Then JSON editor, I just keep it as it is, and then I create subscription. Okay, okay, the subscription has been created. So as you can see, we have two subscriptions for this topic. One that is an email that will be sent to this email address, and one a lambda function that will be triggered when the site goes down. And this is actually, the site is live, so I cannot test it, but I can show you my other lambda functions, which actually works fine when they go down. So you can see my other health checks. These are the two sites that I just created in health check, and it works fine when the site is up, and it's fine when it's down. As you can see, it's sometimes goes down and it automatically goes up. Okay, so I think this will give you a basic idea how you can automate your rebooting process based on your server up and down time, and it will make your life much easier in terms of managing those small instances and make sure they are always up. So that's it for today. I hope I will give you some new tips in coming days. Till then, goodbye, and now go play.